أشهدك يا رب.
الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
لا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله تعالى بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون، فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن استنى بسنته واهتدى بهديه إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل بدعة ضلالة. My dear respected brothers in Islam and sisters in Islam, let me begin by first asking the brothers to move forward and fill in any gaps, thereby making room for your brothers who will come late. I also humbly request you turn off these electronic devices, cell phones and pagers, which have a tendency to ring at the most inappropriate time and disturb us during our ibadah. And last but not least, I humbly request that you open your ears, your hearts, and your minds to what I'm about to say. Brothers and sisters, one of the primary duties of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and purposes for his appointment was to clarify and provide a practical example of the highest standard of moral character and righteous conduct. He himself declared as much, saying, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I have only been appointed, I have been sent for no other reason than to implement and practically demonstrate righteous character. That being the case, when he began to lay the foundation of Islam in the early days of his mission in Mecca, he focused on two fundamental pillars of the deen. Number one, at-tawheed, pure, unadulterated monotheism. Number two, husnul khuluq, fine morals and good manners. He emphasized the latter so much that when people would hear him preach, they thought his message was confined to it, confined, exclusive to husnul khuluq. This is indicated by the hadith of Abi Dharr, who said, لَمَّا بَلَغَنِي مَبْعَثُ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ وَسَلَّمْ قُلْتُ لِي أَخِي إِرْكَبْ إلى هذا الوادي فاسمع من قوله فرجع فقال إنما رأيته يأمر بمكارم الأخلاق. When the news of the Prophet's emergence reached me, I said to my brother, ride to that valley and hear what he is preaching. When he returned, he said, I saw him commanding the people with the most excellent standard of behavior. And there are many other examples, brothers and sisters, of the emphasis on character and manners in the prophetic sunnah. For example, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, مَا مِن شَيْءٍ أَثْقَلُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ مِنْ حُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ. There is nothing weightier in the scales on the day of judgment than good character. And he said, he was asked, O Messenger of Allah, what is the best thing that any servant has been given? Did he say money? Did he say free time? Did he say children? Did he say property? La wallah. قال خير ما أعطي العبد حسن الخلق. He said the best thing any servant has ever been given is good character. He also explained to us that believers are on different levels in terms of their faith. There are some who their faith is weak and deficient and on the verge of evaporating. And some who their faith has grown so strong and so complete that they've reached the pinnacle, the height of faith. And then he taught us, he said, وَأَكْمَلْ مُؤْمِنِينَ إِيمَانًا أَحْسَنُهُمْ خُلُقًا. And he said, the believer with the most complete faith is not the one who has this or that, but rather the one who has the finest character and the best manners. And when he wanted to send Mu'adh ibn Jabal to Al-Yemen as his ambassador, He wanted to give him some parting words of advice, and in that wasiyah, he told him, وَخَالِقِ النَّاسِ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. He told him, and treat the people with good character. Mind your manners in your interactions with others. My dear respected brothers and sisters in al-Islam, despite all of the Prophet's emphasis, good character, manners, and interpersonal relations do not receive the amount of attention and importance from today's Muslims that they should. In many cases, our Islam has become a collection of rituals, a body without a soul. Our focus has become almost exclusively external, with little or no attention given to internal things like sincerity, humility, compassion, selflessness, tolerance, open-mindedness, altruism, and not being shallow or prejudiced or worldly. Perhaps the problem is that we are products of our environment. Perhaps the cold, ruthless, eat or be eaten, kill or be killed mentality of those around us has desensitized us, has numbed us, made us not feel anything. Or perhaps the demands of our modern lifestyle that moves at a breakneck pace has led us to believe that we simply don't have time to be nice to people or care about how our behavior affects others. Brothers and sisters, whatever the reason, whatever the justification, whatever the excuse, it's time for us to remind ourselves that Islam, at its core, is a religion of good character. Our Prophet, the one we claim to love, admire, and follow, was a man of character. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. And indeed, you, O Muhammad, have achieved an exalted standard of character. Not only was he a man of character among men of character, nay, he was the gold standard of good character. As Allah says, لَقَدْ كَانْ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. Indeed, you have the most excellent example in the Messenger of Allah. So we need to turn to that example, measure our character against it, and reform those aspects of our character and conduct that don't measure up to His standard, to His exalted standard. And we hope to do this, or at least begin this process, in the second khutbah. Hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak an nabina Muhammad. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الإمام ابن القيم has compiled some of the qualities and characteristics of the Prophet's character in his book Zad al-Ma'ad. And I want to share with you a sampling of the character of this great man that we need to pattern ourselves after when it comes to what? His character. Ibn al-Qayyim, he writes, كَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ وَسَلَّمْ يُحِبُّ الصِّدْقِ وَيُبْغِذُ الْكَذِبِ بَلْ مَا كَانَ خُلُقٌ أَبْغَذَ إِلَيْهِ مِنَ الْكَذِبِ وَقِيلَ لَهُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ إِنَّكَ تُجَاعِبُنَا فَقَالَ إِنِّي لَا أَقُولُ لَا أَقُولُ إِلَّا حَقًّا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he used to appreciate honesty and truthfulness and despise lying and falsehood. Indeed, there was no quality more despised by the Messenger of Allah than lying. Once it was said to him, O Messenger of Allah, but you most certainly joke with us. Certainly when you joke, sometimes you at least bend the truth, right? Whereupon he said, I only say the truth even when I'm joking. وَكَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ تَوَاضِعًا غَايَةَ التَّوَاضُعَ سَابَقَ بِنَفْسِهِ الْأَقْدَامِ وَصَارَعَ وَخَصَفَ نَعْلَهُ بِيَدِهِ وَرَقَعَ ثَوْبَهُ بِيَدِهِ وَرَقَعَ دَلْوَهُ وَحَلَبَ شَاتَهُ وَفَلَى ثَوْبَهُ وَخَدَمَ أَهْلَهُ وَنَفْسَهُ وَحَمَلَ مَعَهُمُ اللَّبِنَ فِي بِنَاءِ الْمَسْجِدِ وَرَبَطَ عَلَى بَطْنِهِ الْحَجْرَ مِنَ الْجُوءِ تَارَةً وَشَبِعَ تَارَةً وَأَضَافَ وَأُضِيفَ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was extremely humble. He used to have foot races and wrestling matches with his companions. He used to mend his own sandals, patch his own garment, and repair his own bucket. He would also milk his sheep with his own blessed hands and wash his clothes himself. He would serve his family and himself instead of asking or expecting to be served. He carried bricks with his companions and participated in the building of the masjid. He tied stones to his waist out of hunger sometimes and ate to his fill sometimes. And he hosted on occasion, and he was hosted from time to time. قال ابن عباس كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يجلس على الأرض ويأكل على الأرض ويعتقل الشاه ويجيب دعوة المملوك على خبز الشعير وروي يوم الأحزاب ينقل التراب وقد وار التراب بياض بطنه. ابن عباس, he said, the Messenger of Allah used to sit on the ground and eat while sitting on the ground, attend to the sheep and accept the invitation of slaves to have barley bread with them. And he was seen during the preparations for the Battle of Al-Ahzab, shoveling, removing soil and assisting in the digging of the trench, such that the whiteness of his stomach was concealed by the dirt which had stuck to it. وَكَانَ يُحِبُّ التَّخْفِيفُ وَالْيُسْرَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَقَالَتْ عَائِشَةَ مَا خُيِّرَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ بَيْنَ أَمْرَيْنِ قَطْ إِلَّا أَخَذَ بِأَيْسِرِهِمَا فَإِنْ كَانَ إِثْمًا كَانَ أَبْعَدَ النَّاسِ إِلَيْهِ. Ibn al-Qayyim, he said, the Prophet used to love moderation and to make things easy for people. Aisha said, the Messenger of Allah was never given a choice between two matters, except that he chose the easiest of them, provided that it wasn't sinful. مَا لَمْ يَكُنْ إِثْمًا. And if it was sinful, he would be the farthest of people from it. وَكَانَ هَدْيُهُ فِي الْكَلَامِ أَكْمَلُ الْهَدِي. قَالَتْ Aisha, مَا كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَسْرِدْ صَرْدَكُمْ هَذَا وَلَكِنْ كَانَ يَتَكَلَّمُ بِكَلَامٍ بَيِّنٍ فَصْلٍ يَحْفَظُهُ مَنْ جَلَسَ إِلَيْهِ وَكَانَ كَثِيرًا مَا يُعِيدُ الْكَلَامِ ثَلَاثًا لِيُعْقَلَ عَنْهُ وَكَانَ طَوِيلُ السُّكُوتِ لَا يَتَكَلَّمُ فِي غَيْرِ حَاجَةٍ وَلَا يَتَكَلَّمُ فِي مَا لَا يَعْنِيهِ وَلَا يَتَكَلَّمُ إِلَّا فِيمَا يَرْجُو ثَوَابَهُ. Indeed, his example in regards to speech was the most excellent example. Aisha, she said, the Messenger of Allah did not speak with haste the way you people do. Rather, he spoke in a manner that was both clear and concise, which could be memorized by those in his presence. He would also, in many cases, repeat what he said three times so that it could be easily understood. He would remain silent for long periods of time, never speaking without need to do so. He never spoke about a matter that did not concern him and never spoke about an issue except one for which he hoped to be rewarded. وَإِذَا كَرِهَ الشَّيْءَ عُرِفَ فِي وَجْهِهِ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ فَاحِشًا وَلَا مُتَفَحِّشًا وَلَا صَخَّابًا وَكَانَ جُلُّ ضَحِكِهِ التَّبَسُّمُ بَلْ كُلُّهُ التَّبَسُّمُ يضحك مما يضحك منه مما يتعجب منه ويستغرب وقوعه ويستندر. If he dislikes something, it could be seen in his face. He was not foul or lewd in speech, nor was he loud or obnoxious. Most of his laughter was smiling. Nay, all of it was smiling. He used to laugh at his normally conspicuous matters, which surprised him. But he was يجيب الدعوة ويمشي مع الأرملة والمسكين والضعيف في حوائجهم وسمع مديح الشعر وأثاب عليه ولكن ما قيل فيه من المديح فهو جزء يسير جدا من محامده. He used to advise and seek advice. He used to visit the sick, attend funerals, and accept invitations. He would walk with the widow, the poor and the weak, and fulfill their needs and solve their problems. He didn't think it was beneath him to walk with someone who was from the disregarded people from society. He also listened to poetry in his tribute, and he rewarded the poet. But what was mentioned in the poem was only a fraction of what he possessed of good qualities and attributes entitling him to praise. وكان من أخلاقه أنه جميل العشرة دائم البشر يداعب أهله ويتلطف بهم ويوسعهم نفقته ويضاحك النساء حتى إنه كان يسابق عائشة أم المؤمنين يتودد إليها بذلك. And it was from his character that he had a very beautiful way of dealing with his wives. He was always pleasant. He used to play and frolic with his family and treat them kindly. He would spend on them generously and make them laugh. He even raised Aisha, the mother of the believers, seeking to increase the love between them thereby. وكان ينام مع المرأة من نسائه في شعار واحد يضع عن كتفيه الرداء وينام بالإزار. وكان إذا صلى العشاء يدخل منزله يسمر مع أهله قليلا قبل ما ينام أو قبل أن ينام يؤانسهم بذلك. He used to sleep with his wives under one covering, taking off his cloak, sleeping only in his lower garment and using his cloak to cover her and himself. When he prayed at Isha, he would enter his home and chat with his wife before sleeping to entertain her and amuse her thereby. وكان يقول استوسوا بالنساء خيرا ورفقا بالقوارير. And he used to say, treat women kindly and be gentle with these vessels of glass. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, this is your prophet. This is his character. And where are we from this character? We need to do better. We need to measure up. He's the standard. He's the best of them all. And if we are really Muslims, and if we're really lovers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then we have to believe and act like we believe that he's the best example. May Allah make us from those who take him as an example. Allahumma arin al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna tiba'ah. Wa arin al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinabah. Allahumma izz al-islam wal-muslimin wa dhill al-shirk wal-mushrikin wa dammir a'da'aka a'da' al-millati wal-deen. وانصر عبادك الموحدين يا قوي يا عزيز. اللهم من أرادنا أو أراد ديننا أو إخوان المسلمين في أي مكان بسوء فأشغله في نفسه واجعل كيده في نحري واجعل تدبيره تدميرا عليه يا قوي يا عزيز. اللهم اشفي مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم اشفي مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم اشفي مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقينا عذاب النار. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وقوموا إلى صلاتكم.
الله الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا واعتدلوا تقاربوا استووا واعتدلوا الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. صلوات ورحمة. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله. استغفر الله. اللهم أنت السلام.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, salatu wassalam, rasulullah. I have a couple of announcements, brother. Masjid, our target is to collect every week $5,000, brother. We are